Hi, welcome back to the Windows 8.1 UX Design Jumpstart. My name is Martin Tierian. I'm User Experience Evangelist with Microsoft in the Netherlands. With me is Chris.
Hi, I'm Chris Mayo. I'm a User Experience Evangelist with Microsoft as well.
So in this session, we'll talk about the share contract and how you can share in apps. And again, we already talked about this in contracts. Apps working together are more efficient and you can get more complete end-to-end scenarios for the users. Let's say you have an app where you can show pictures, for instance, but you don't have all the functionality there to maybe modify the pictures or have special effects there or other things. So just by combining apps together, you can have that complete experience for the user. So it makes your app more useful for the user, or you can be a very good addition to another app, so the user will use your app as well. So single app cannot deliver all complete scenarios, right? So how does share work in Windows 8? Well, let's see. Let's go to a web page. Just a random one. I picked MSN. Here's MSN, and well, there's some information here. There's an article. Let's go to that article. So I'm still on the web. This is what we all know. And you see here is a picture, there's the title there, and there's the information there. And you see here in the middle of the page, there's a functionality there to share to Facebook, to tweet this article, or to email this article. Now the problem of this implementation is that if you want to do that in your app, you have to implement like all these things that are popular now, and if a new one comes up or the interface changes, you have to change your app because you have to talk to all these APIs or make it possible to share with those apps. And that's problematic to do because you don't want to put in that much work because it costs a lot of money, right? So just by using the share contract, that also can be used in combination with IE in this case, just go to the charms and select share. And now Windows shows me a complete list of apps that I have installed on my machine and that can receive this kind of information. So in this case, I want to read this article later, and we've seen this app used over and over again, but it makes a point. So I'll just select the reading list, bookmark it for later. It shows the a flyout here with that information in the reading list app, and I just can add it to the reading list. Now when I go to the reading list, here you see that the information is added today, and I can find that information here in this app. So now IE and the reading list app just work together by using the share contract. And all the information like the abstract and the title and the image is here, and of course the link, and I can see where it's coming from. So that's in basic how share works in Windows 8. Now let's see what's actually happening under the covers. So this is an image slide that shows what the structure is. So on the left-hand side, you see there's the web page in this case. You see the title, the image, some text there. In the middle, you see the Windows share pane, and it shows the complete list of apps that can receive that kind of information. And just by selecting the reading list, you see the share target UI on the right-hand side, the flyout that we saw before, where the article is as well, so I can have the app do with that information what he wants, send it off or store it or whatever. So this is on the left-hand side the share source, and on the right-hand side is the share target. And those are important concepts to understand because your app can be a share source or can be maybe a share target or both.
Right.
So let's see what it means to be a share source. So in Windows 8, there was no default behavior in share. When you went to an app and went to the share pane and there was no share contract implemented, it just said, this app has nothing to share. We changed that to Windows 8.1. So by default, when I share something, so when I go here and go to share, you see that I can share a screenshot. And when I'm in an app, let's go to IE again and open this up, go to share. you see that I can send a screenshot or send a link to the app itself. So these are very easy ways to have the most common scenarios there. So a screenshot and the link to the app is always in Windows. So it's just by thinking, how can your app add value to the sharing experience? Do you have extra information that you can share or users want to share with others or through other apps? So think of those scenarios. If a screenshot or a link to the app is enough, don't implement a share contract. Just do it if you can add value. When you think about sharing, you should think about what kind of information can you share, what type of content. Is it text or images or links or other things that you want to see, what you see on the page and you can share to another page. And you have all kind of data formats that you can use. So these are the standard data formats that you can use sharing information through the share contract. So you can share something in plain text or HTML, and you see formatted text, bitmaps, files, URI. Those are all things that you can share, but you can also share your custom data formats. When you think of custom data formats, for instance, here you see schema.org, there are a number of schemas defined there. So in this case, for instance, for a recipe. So someone came up with an idea, what are all the attributes you need for a recipe? What's the structure of that? So there must be a title and maybe some ingredients and things like that. So there's a standard definition there. And you can use a schema like that to make up your own custom data type. So you can share that between apps. So let's say you have a food app or a recipe app, and you want to share that with maybe some other app that also knows about recipes. You can share that exact information. So this is very powerful. The disadvantage of that is that it's not accessible by that many apps, because if you implement it in your app, there won't be that many apps that implement the same schema, right, or maybe have the same version of the schema. So make sure that this is a very well thought decision if you use custom formats. Of course, for line of business applications, it might make more sense if you have different apps and you want them to work together that belong in one package, right? There are also, in the data package, when you provided to the through the share contract, there are some extra properties. So already in Windows 8, you gave the title and description and the thumbnail. Now new in Windows 8 are some extra some changes in the links you can provide. So in Windows 8, you can provide one link. In Windows 8.1, you can provide an application link and a web link, and we'll see what that means in a second. You can also provide a logo or logo background color. That's what we saw when sharing from MSN to the reading list app. When the pane was there, you saw the logo of IE was there, or of even of MSN. That was provided by IE to the through the sharing contract. Now, application link versus web link. So, as I said, you can provide two links to another application if you're sharing something. And what's the use of that? What happened in Windows 8 is that most apps would share a web link, because a web link is universal. I can share it through mail and send it to someone who's not on Windows 8, and they can still use it and access the data. But on the other hand, when I want to share information and to people who have the same app maybe on the Windows 8 environment, I want them to open the app again or to open my app, because I provided some information and I want someone else to read the same information in my app, so bring them back inside of my app. That's why we added application link as well as a possibility. And you use the web link if you do cloud sharing. So if you want to share some with someone and you have no idea what they will be using, it's somewhere in the world. But if you do client sharing, so you know it's going to a Windows 8 machine, you use application link. And by default, the share source provides both to the share contract. So, for instance, when I go to news here, to the news app, and go to let's select this article, and now I add it to the reading list. Bookmark it for later. There we go. And now we'll go to the let me close this one. So it's closed now. Go to the reading list. The article is there. When I open it now, it opens up the app instead of the web. It doesn't open the web page. So what happened here is that the reading list got the application link and stored that in the reading list instead of the web link. So the reading list make the decision which link was used. The news app just provide both. And I can show that by going back to this one again, to this app, to the news item. Oh, let me go back here. This is the news item. And share it again. But now go to mail. And here you see that here's a link. There's the article here. No, I don't want to add it. Go away. Here's the link, but there's also a link, open this in news. So in this case, the mail app got the link to go to the web, but he also provides a link here to go to the app, not the web, but the app. So that's the decision the target app makes how it will use it. So provide these kind of links is very useful in that scenario to bring people back inside of your app instead of just going to the web. So some guidelines for being a share source. Provide hints for to help users find core share scenarios. Maybe it's very important to share specific information. You can provide hints in the UI and just open up the share pane for that to show that. Also respect user selections. So let me go back, for instance, to the MSN page and go here, select an article. And now I'll select a piece of text, only this part. And when I share now, go to share, to mail, for instance, you see that the text I selected is here and not the complete article. So that's about user selection. And now you also see it just received the web link now to the page where that information is. So it's really about thinking and respecting the user selection, what he means by sharing the information that's on the screen at that moment. And share links to online content. Download only where required, so don't download everything and put it in the share contract, because then you get a very heavy way of sharing information with each other. So make sure that it's very lightweighted. So that was what a share source is doing. Now let's talk about what a share target is doing. Now, of course, you need a design for being a share target. When your app is started as a share target, most of the time you open a UI and there it's like a flyout, and you have information there that you receive the information and what you will do with it. You provide a share description in the manifest, so it helps users to select your app, and I'll show in a minute what that means. But you also, as a share target, have to make a decision what kind of information you want to receive. So is it just plain text, or is it rich text, or is it just links or images or anything that you can handle in your app? So you have to think about those formats. And maybe there are some custom data formats you want to implement there. And of course, you have to design that UI, and you want to see that same branding of your app there. Now, in this case, we see IE again in an article is shared through the sharing pane. And this is what I talked about being in the manifest. You see that there's reading list, but below that it says bookmark for later. Now, that's new Windows 8.1. In Windows 8, you just had the name of the app and the logo there, but you had no idea what that meant. For instance, in this image, you see now this is still the old People app. So what will happen if I share this page with the People app? No idea. And what actually happens is that you can share it through Facebook, for instance, that's connected in that app. So by providing that extra information for the user, in this case with the reading list bookmark for later, the user knows what will happen if you use that app to share that information. Share pane design. Make sure that it really reflects the brand of your app and the user recognizes being part of your app. So in this case, on the left-hand side, you see the reading list app. We've seen it over and over again. On the right-hand side, you see the flyout, and you see the same color scheme is used there. The same iconography is used, and even the article there, how it showed, you see the same in the reading list app. So it's very recognizable by the user. He knows this is the app I'm using, and he knows where it's going. The share pane width is always 646 pixels, so you have to design for that. So it's part of the system, and it works like the user expects. Some guidelines for the share pane: provide a preview, so don't just accept data, but show what you accepted and what kind of data you will store or send off or etc. So like in this reading list example, you see the title there, the abstract is there, and the image is there. So there's a lot of information that the user knows, oh, this is being stored in that app. Also, acknowledge user actions. Maybe some extra stuff can be done here, some extra actions. And there's a way to, maybe when I send it off, in the reading list it's very fast because it's local. But maybe in your app, something extra processing is being done, and it takes some time. With this new dismiss UI method, it's possible to just dismiss the UI, but still keep on working as a shared target to process your data and then send it off. But the user is not bothered with that process. He just shared it and it's done for him. So that's a better experience for the user. So think of that as well. Make it very light and easy experience for the user. Quick links is also a very important feature to use. And this is especially for communication scenarios. And you might think of other scenarios where it's useful. But from the search app, you can add a quick link to, for instance, in this case, I already sent an email to Chris last time I shared something. The next time I share something, I already have the quick link emailing Chris there. And this won't get a very long list. There are only a few ones remembered. But it's a very easy way, because if this is something I do over and over again, it's a very fast experience for me to immediately send it off to Chris and without typing his name again. So make use of that if it's part of the scenario that you have in your app. And also include a descriptive title and image. So in this case, you see that it's going to the mail app, but not the mail icon is there, but there's a gray box with a white icon there, and that's Chris in this case. When I'm mailing to myself, which is a bit awkward, you see there's a picture there. But make sure that the user recognizes what's happening there and not only use the icon there of the app itself. Make it really custom for the user. So if we see what we've talked about in this session, people want to share things, share it off through Twitter or Facebook or email, or maybe share it with another app so they can do extra functionality in that app with the same content. The share contract makes that possible to have really connecting app together, and apps together and make the complete scenarios possible. Windows does all the heavy lifting, so as a share source, you provide the information, provide all the types of data you want to share, and Windows just looks up all the apps that can receive the data, show it, and so the user can really focus on the scenario, and you and your app can also only have to do the things to provide the data or receive the data. And also think, of course, of the design of the share targets. When you receive information, make sure that you pay attention to that share pane as well, because that's so much easier for the user to understand what's happening, and he will use that even after. Again, when you want to do a lap on share, think in your app, is there a reason to be a share source, or can you be a share target? And what do you have to do to implement that? What kind of information will you share? What types of data, or if you are a target, what types of data can you receive, and what will you do with it, and do you want to give feedback to the user, and what's the styling of the pane? So this is an exercise that you can do for your app. Of course, there are the well-known resources and the design center. There are guidelines for sharing content, but also for creating custom data formats. And on the Dev Center, there are numerous examples with JavaScript and also with C# and XAML, how you can implement it in your app or be a share source or be a share target. And that's it for sharing. So we have a question. Can I invoke a share target from code bypassing the user interaction? No, the thing is that you have no idea in your app what other apps are installed. Of course, there are ways to start other apps, but that's not sharing, and that's not done through the share contract. So the idea of the share contract is just to invoke it through the share contract and let the user decide which app will receive that information. That's the whole purpose of sharing. And I think that's it. No more questions. So I thank you for your time, and we'll be back in 10 minutes. Yep. With the next session. Thanks.
Awesome. Thanks.